Hello guys, this is Manoj from Abhi and Roy. Today we will be discussing about the constraint layouts. So after a bit of explanation about the constraint layout, you can see over here we're gonna build this particular layout as an example. Okay, let's get started. Okay, constraint layouts are the view groups which allows to create the responsive user interface. So which means when we use the constraint layouts, we can even build the responsive layouts. So the main advantage of using the constraint layout is it automatically handles the responsiveness among all the devices, which means when we create a layout for a particular screen size, this layout automatically handles of all the other screen sizes as well. So we don't need to create or build the different layouts for the different screens. So that's the main advantage of using the constraint layout. This layout is the default layout in Android Studio. So let's suppose think you create an XML file. That XML file comes with the constraint layout, so that the constraint layout is the default layout for the Android. And this layout is mainly known for the single parent hierarchy. So we can even build or create the whole layout with only the single view group, which is the parent. So these layouts contains the constraint points. So every view has a 4 points, which are start, end, top, bottom constraints. So with this use of constraint points, we will connect to the either the parent or the views which are present inside it. So remember guys, at least we need to connect one left, which is one vertical and one horizontal constraints. If you won't connect anything, so the Android will show an error. When you run this app, it will throw the views at the same page. So everything will be mixed if we are not going to connect any constraints. So when we use the constraint layout, we can even build the clean UI code so that the performance of the app and the user experience will be much better. But for the beginners, constraint layout is a bit tricky to understand. But trust me guys, when you start building the layouts with the constraint layout, you can see the beauty of it. Okay. So that's about the constraint layout. Now let's see the important attributes which we are going to discuss in the constraint layout. As we see below, I listed some of the attributes of constraint layout which I thought of important. And the first one which we have here, layout constraint top to the top of. So as the name says, this attribute is used for the top constraint points. So every view has 4 constraint points. So this attribute is represents a stop constraint. With this attribute, we will connect the view with the parent or the view group or the other views which are present in that particular layout. And the second which we have here, the constraint bottom to the bottom of. So as the same like the top, this attribute is used to connect the bottom constraint point to the other views or the parent view which are present in that particular layouts. So as we see here, left and right is the same. We will connect the left attribute is used to connect the left constraints and the right attribute is used to connect the right constraints. So don't worry guys, all these attributes I'm gonna explain with an example in this video only. So and then we have here the margin gone. This particular attribute is very, very important when we have, let's suppose think we have 3 views. So one view was in the gone state and the first view is connected to the second view. The first view was in the gone state, so the second view have only 8 dB margin and I need to give 32 GPS margin. So with this help of margin gone, we can give that particular view how much margin we need. So when that particular connected, which means the first layout comes to the gone state, to the visible state, this this said the second view will be having only 8 dpi as its margin. So this one also I'll explain with an example so that you can understand easily. And the last one which we have here, the chain attribute. So the chain attribute used when any requirement we have, like spreading a views equally, like horizontally or vertically. Let's suppose think we have 3 buttons in a view, so we need to spread them equally horizontally. We need to place in a row that it needs to occupy the same equal height. So in that case we will use chains horizontal. We will align the views horizontally changed. And let's suppose think we have 3 buttons which we need to align it vertically, so then we use the chains vertical, so vertically aligned chains. So this is about the chain, guys. Now let's see with the single layout what's the structure will be when we create the parent as a relative layout or a linear layout and the constraint layout. So here you can see that this is the view which we are going to create with an example, but for now we will see if we use the relative layers as parent how the structure of the code will look like. So here you can see that we used a parent as the relative layout, and inside it what we did, we separated this view, this particular view which has the image and the text name text, so we separated it with the relative layout. So we placed it image view and the text view inside it. So and again what we did, we have 3 buttons, 3 text views and a button. So for that what we used the relative linear layout, and we placed inside it all the 3 text and 1 button. This is how the structure of this particular layout will look like when we use the relative layers as a parent. Now let's see the same layout how it will look like when we create it with a linear layout. We placed parent as a linear layout, and inside it what we did, we separated this view with the linear layout. So we placed an image view and the text view inside an linear layout, and we have 3 buttons over here, the same as we seen in the relative layout. We placed all the 3 text and a button inside the linear layout. So when we create or when we use the parent as a linear layout, the structure will look like this. But now our concept is about the constraint layouts. Now let's see when we create the same layout how it will look like the structure of the XML file. So this is where you can see, guys, we used the constraint layout as our parent. So now inside it we have an image as same we seen with the linear layout and the relative layout. The structure, if you look the structure, you can see that how clean it was. There is no other sub attribute or view group. We don't need to use any other view group inside this parent. So we can place all the views inside a single parent. Now we will go to the Android Studio and we will see how these attributes will work with an example. Okay, I just created a basic project in Android Studio, guys, and I named it as constraint layout. So now the first thing which I want to show you was the guidelines. So the guidelines are more useful for us when we are building the UIs. Let's suppose thing we just add the vertical guideline over here. So now the guideline was added, you can see here, and it was 20 dp as it was constrained as 20 dp. So these guidelines we cannot see when we run the app in the mobile. So these are used for the only the developing purpose. So now what I'm gonna do was, here you can see layout constraint guideline begin, I'm gonna give it as 22. So now let's suppose drag and drop the button over here. So what I'll do was, I'll constrain this with this guideline. We can constrain our views with the guidelines as well. So you can see I constrained it with the guideline. Now what I'll do is I'll constrain it on the top. Let's add another horizontal guideline on the top, and we will select that one, and we will give the same as 22 dp, and we will constrain the top constraint point with the guideline with the horizontal guideline. Okay, now you can see with this guidelines we constrained a button. So that's how we will use these guidelines. So now just quickly I'll remove all these things and we'll move to the first attribute which we discussed, layout constraint to the left of. So what I first what I'll do was I'll add the button. So as I told you, for every view we have four constraint points, left, right, top and bottom. So we need to constrain it either to the parent or else to the other view. First we will see how we will constrain with the parent. So you have your button, just drag and constrain to the parent. Now when we go to the code, you can see over here it was constrained to the parent. So here we have constraint start and it same as constraint left. So that's how the constraint start or the left attribute used. Now what I'll do was, so I'll do it here so that you can understand what's really happening in the XML file. So what I'll do, the next attribute which we have was, we will take the constraint top to the top of. We will constrain it the same way, we will constrain it to parent as well as, and if you want we can constrain to another view also. So now for now we will constrain to top, the parent. So you can see over here the error was gone and also the constraint top to the top of parent was added. So we added our constraint top constraint point to the parent. Now I will do quickly, I'll add the left constraint or the end constraint to the parent also. So you can see over here the end constraint, and I'll drag and drop this bottom constraint also to the bottom of the screen so that you can see over here. So you can see over here when we drag and drop it here, the button was aligned in the center, and we can see here constraint bottom to the bottom of attributes also added. So these are the four attributes for use to place a button wherever we need. And also let's go to the design. Also we have here a panel which we use to give the margins. So when we move this, it will move up. When we move this, it will move down. Okay, you can even give the margins over here. So what I'll do is I will remove this one, just the start one, just remove it. And what we will do, we will give the margin of 24 dB 24. So you can see here if you hover on it, you can see 24 as a, we gave here as a margins. So that's how we can even give the margins over here. So now what I will do is I'll quickly remove all the constraints of this button, and we will see how we can constrain this with the another view. So for that we need another view. Let's suppose I'll add another button. So what we will do now is we will constrain both the buttons. When we click on it, we got the bottom and I'm constraining to the top of the second button. So as you can see here, the button automatically moved because we constrained it with the bottom of the second button. So now we can move this and we can do whatever we want with this button. So we constrained it with the bottom. So now I'll constrain this with the parent so that we can constrain with both the parent as well as the views, other views also. This is how we will use the constraints, both where we use for our parents or else we will use for the other views which we're gonna build. So now we seen all the attributes which we discussed, like a constraint left and constraint right, constraint top and the constraint bottom. Now we need to see what is this margin gone. So as I told you, the margin gone also the very important attributes. So what I will do is I will quickly add a button, and not one, I'll add the two buttons, and I'll constrain the button 2 to the button 1 with the left or the begin constraint point. Let me quickly do that. I'll constrain it. So what I'll do was, for this one I'll give a margin of 12 dB, and for this I'll constrain to the parent. And what I will do is, I will give this as same 24 dB. So you can see here, and I'll align them center vertically. So you can see over here we have still the errors. So it was telling not vertically constrained, so we didn't constrain it vertically. So I will add it to the parent as well as the bottom also to the parent. So you can see that we got it, the error was removed. And same for button 2 also, we will do the same. We will add the top of the constraint and the bottom of the constraint as well. So okay, so here topic was the gone margin. So you can see over here, when we gave 24 as the left margin or the starting margin, and for this we constrained to this one and we gave 24 dB as a margin. So now what I want to do was, when this button goes to the gone state, which is visibility gone, then I need to give this button margin as 50 dB. So how we will do that? By using the gone margin attribute. Let's go to the code, and what I will do was, this particular button I'll select it and I will keep visibility as gone. But now if you see, we have still the margin of 24, but I need, for this button I need 50 when the second button was not visible. So what I will do was, gone margin, the attribute was gone margin. So where we need to give? On the left side. So let's use the left side of 50 dB. As we discussed, we need 50 dB. I gave it as 50 dB now. So what I'll do, I will, so you can see over here, when we select this button, we will get the 50 dB as its margin. So now what I will do was, I will remove, I will keep this visibility as gone state to visible state, so that you can see the button, the margin between these two buttons came 24. But when I remove this button, you can clearly check that the margin will be 50 dB. The 50 dB. I don't think this was the right, but you can see with the width for the 20. So let me remove this attribute, and we will see the 24 dB as a margin. You can see that the button will move. So this is the 24 dB. When I place that margin gone, so you can see that the 50 dB as a margin we are getting. Okay, now what we will do, the last attribute is chains. So we will do the we will check how this attribute will work. Let me quickly add three buttons over here, one, and place it in the center. Now what we are going to do is, we will select all the buttons. Just click on, hold on shift and select all the three buttons, and let's go here and choose horizontally. So all the buttons are now horizontal, and also if you want, you can choose it vertically as well, so that those are aligned vertically. Now select all the three buttons and right click on it. You can see that we have here the chains, and we have horizontal chain. Let's click on spread. So now you cannot see any change, but when we go to the split and change the pair chain style to spread inside, so you can see that all the buttons, the starting and the ending button gone to the last ending part of the screen. And also we have another called packed. So you can see over here, all the three buttons are combined with each other. There is no margin also. So this is how the chain attribute will work, guys. So we can basically, we will align the same width, or if you are horizontally, or same height to the chains, the views which are placed in the chain. So we will keep for spread. And now let's go to the design and click on this and change the width to 0 dp. So you can see first the middle button occupies two parts of the first two buttons, so it is 2 times bigger than these two buttons. If you click on the last button and just same as like that give the 0 dp, you can see that these two are in the equal size and this button was WAP content. And now if you change that to 0 dp, you can see all the three buttons are aligned, the width as same. Now let's create the vertical chain. So just remove the buttons and add three buttons. And now what we'll do is we'll constrain this top to the parent and this bottom, this top to this layout and this one as over here. Okay, now select all the three buttons and go to here and place it vertically so that buttons are placed vertically, and we will even keep this as horizontal. So to remove the bug, to remove the error which was causing us, the same for rest of the buttons as well we need to do. Okay, now you can see that error all gone, and please select all the three buttons by clicking on the shift and click on right click on it and change. You can see the vertical and add spread. So you cannot see anything over here, as you know guys, we are using spread. And if you change it to spread inside, you can see that the buttons have went to the one corners of the screen, and if you use pat, it will shrink together. So this is about the chain, what are horizontal vertical chains guys. So in this video we discussed all the attributes like constraint the top, constraint left button, left points, and constraint bottom point, constraint top points. And also we discussed about the gone margin and chains. So in the next video, what we're going to do, we will build this particular layout using the constraint layout. So that's it from this video guys. Until then, keep learning, take care, bye bye.